Hi, my name is Representative Liz Hanbidge, and along with Steve Malagheri, I'm introducing a ban on declawing cats for cosmetic or aesthetic reasons, or for reasons of convenience. Yeah, I see some clapping out here. So I come from a long line of animal lovers, and for a long time we had cats in my household when I was growing up that were declawed, because we didn't realize the impact that that had on cats. I had Alice and Frog, who were both declawed up front, and then I had a cat called Buster, who was feral, who we brought into our home, who we left intact. And I didn't realize as a child and growing up that declawing isn't like a manicure. It's not even just the removal of the cat's nails. The bones, tendons, ligaments on a cat's legs, feet, are surgically amputated. And if you think about sort of amputation for convenience rather than declawing for convenience, it really sort of horrifies. It can lead to paw pain, infection, lameness, nerve damage, and bone spurs for the cats. The American Veterinary Medical Association opposes declawing as it leads to undesirable behaviors, including inappropriate elimination, aggression, and biting. It also discourages it as an elective procedure. This is an important distinction from a medical need. My bill and Rep. Malagheri's bill does realize that sometimes it is medically necessary to declaw cats, such as in the instance of when there is toe cancer. And there's an exemption in this bill to allow for when it's medically necessitated. The ASPCA strongly opposes cat declawing, as cat's claws are a vital tool in their socialization, protection, balance, ability to live normal and full lives. Declawing also doesn't show that it helps cats get adopted or cared for in any better way. There's actually anecdotal evidence that shows that cats who are declawed are less likely to be adopted because they exhibit more bad behaviors like biting and refusing to use a litter box. We're a little bit behind the rest of the world. Declawing is banned in many places, including most of Europe. And in Israel, it can actually be punished for up to a year in jail if you declaw your cat. So alternatives to declawing include training, nail trimming, nail caps, natural cat pheromones to reduce anxiety. I know that the world is full of cat lovers, myself included, and I think many of my colleagues. And a lot of us didn't realize the impact that declawing had on cats. There are already many veterinarians that don't do declawing for convenience purposes, but this bill is one of the ways that we can make sure that everybody knows the negative impacts of declawing on cats and that we can protect our feline friends. So I hope you'll consider co-sponsoring the bill. Thank you.